Hello friends, welcome to a new video of Subhra's Biology, and today we will read sterilization. As you know, this sterilization is a broad topic and it is divided into physical type and chemical type. And in this class I am just going to tell about the physical type of sterilization, and the next class I will be telling about the chemical type of sterilization. So then here we go for the sterilization. What is sterilization? Sterilization is a process of any surface or article or a medium is free from all microorganisms. When any surface is made free from all microorganisms, then this medium is called as sterilized. So this is broadly divided into physical type of sterilization and the next type of chemical type of sterilization. So in this physical type of sterilization, I have drawn a schematic diagram of sterilization. In this physical type of sterilization, first one is the sunlight. As you can see here, sunlight is an active germicidal effect it has. Because sunlight contains UV rays, so it is a natural method of sterilization. So water in tanks, for example, water in tanks, rivers or lakes, these are sterilized by natural method, and this method, sunlight method. So this is the first type of physical type of sterilization. And next we are going for the second. And this is the heat. This is the second type of physical type of sterilization. And it kills the microorganisms by denaturation of bacterial proteins. So this is divided into two types, dry heat and moist heat. So dry heat procedures contains four types of procedures. First one can be red heat, second one can be flaming, third one can be incineration, and fourth one can be hot aerobic. So in this red heat, what happens? For example, inoculation of wire loops, needles, teeth or forceps, these are the things which are sterilized in this red heat type of sterilization. And in case of flaming, glass slides, scalpels or mouths of culture tubes, these are sterilized by this method, flaming type of dry heat sterilization. And in the third one is the incineration, where everything is burnt into ashes. So for example, soil dressings, beddings, animal carcasses, these are just burned by an instrument called incinerator. So next one is the hot air oven, and this is very much important, hot air oven. So this is a adequate air is there. This is a machine instrument where 160 degrees Celsius temperature for 2 hours you can keep it for, so that sterilization can happen. Glass syringes, petri dishes, test tube, pipettes and flasks are the instruments which are sterilized in this hot air oven. This is the dry heat type of physical sterilization. And next we are going for the moist heat sterilization, and this is divided into three types: at a temperature below 100 degrees Celsius, at a temperature 100 degrees Celsius, and next is the at a temperature greater than 100 degrees Celsius. So at a temperature below 100 degrees Celsius, first one is the pasteurization of milk procedure. In this pasteurization of milk procedure, where we are sterilizing non-sporing pathogens, for example, brucella, mycobacteria, salmonella, etc. And next is the inspeciation. Inspeciation means serum or egg media type of things are sterilized in this type of inspeciation method. And next is the vaccine bath. Vaccine bath means antibiotics or vaccines are sterilized in this type of vaccine bath. Next we are going for at a temperature of 100 degrees Celsius, similar to 100 degrees Celsius. So boiling and tantalization are the process by which we can sterilize anything at a temperature of 100 degrees Celsius. Boiling means, in case of boiling, it kills vegetative forms, but it keeps the sporing form. So better things are preferable. So better type of sterilization are preferable. Next, in case of tantalization, serum or sugar containing media are sterilized in case of tantalization. So next we are going for at a temperature greater than 100 degrees Celsius. At a temperature greater than 100 degrees Celsius, autoclave is there, where it has the temperature 121 degrees Celsius temperature. Autoclave, culture media, gowns, gloves and dressings, the things which are which can be damaged in case of hot air oven, these are the things that are sterilized in case of autoclave. And next we are going for the filtration, and this is the third type of physical sterilization. In case of filtration, the things which are get damaged by heat process, we are sterilizing this by this filtration method. So sera, sugar, antibiotic solutions, these are the things which we just filtrate out. This is a method of sterilization. And next we are going for the radiation. This is the fourth one, and not the last, and this is the last one, physical type of sterilization. In case of radiation, it is divided into two types: ionizing radiation and non-ionizing radiation. In case of ionizing radiations, There we have X-ray, gamma ray, cosmic ray, and in case of non-ionizing radiation, we have infrared ray, UV rays. So in case of ionizing radiation, we know, as we know, X-ray, and the best example is of gamma ray. This is cobalt 60, plastic syringes, swabs, culture plates. These are sterilized in here gamma rays. This is a very important. And next, in case of non-ionizing radiation, infrared, we have syringes and catheters. These are sterilized in case of infrared. And in UV ray, this is very important. Disinfecting enclosed areas such as bacteriological lab, laminar flow, or operation theater. These are sterilized by this of non-ionizing radiation. So this is all about the total physical type of sterilization: sunlight, heat, filtration, radiation. So next class we were going for the chemical type of sterilization. And in the last part, in the next last topic in the sterilization, I will tell you the shortcut how to remember the examples and the examples of all physical and chemical type of sterilization, because it is so lengthy you can't remember this. So I am going to make a video of just 3 to 4 minutes so that you can remember all the types of sterilization in just 2 to 3 minutes. Thank you.